Welcome to It's Your Date with Destiny with Apostle Vivian and Pastor Gemma Duncan of Divine Destiny Worship Center in Diego Martin. For the next 30 minutes, join us as we take you on a journey of maximizing your potential and realizing your goals through Jesus Christ. Whether it's on a Sunday, Tuesday, or Friday, or any other day of the week, a warm welcome awaits you at Divine Destiny Worship Center, a place where your full potential is discovered. Here's a special invitation to join us at...
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. I'm clapping my hands. I want you to clap your hands with me. There's a scripture, Psalm 47. It says, clap your hands, O ye people, shout unto the Lord with a voice of triumph. The word clap, the expression clap your hands in Hebrew gives the imagery of taking a hammer and pounding a nail into a wall or a piece of wood until it disappears. I'm decreeing. That's the kind of anointing God is giving to you right now, and the kind of breakthrough, because he said to me this morning, anoint my hands with oil and really do it like a hammer, pounding as you clap your hands, pounding at that spirit that's entering into families now and causing family feuds. Yes, to boil over into murder, to boil over into what? Into wounding, into family fights. We decree today, I'm clapping my hand three times. And when I'm doing that, I want you to follow me. We're going to put a nail in the middle of that demonic spirit. Families are supposed to live in harmony. So at the count of three, I want you to do it. One, two, three. Here we go again. One, two, three. And this time I make the declaration. One, two, three. We bring family feuds to an end. Let there be peace in your house. In Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. You see, that's the God we serve. He knows what we need. And he knows that in your home, you needed the input, hallelujah, of a strong anointing for agreement. Go read Psalm 133. Behold how good and how pleasant it is for brethren. That's family, to dwell together in unity. And I'm also hearing the Lord talking about there's a pastor and a terrible feuding spirit has arisen among the leaders in that ministry where you are. I'm going to release the hammer of God's grace to bore a hole in the very head of that demonic spirit. In the name of Jesus, one, two, three, receive it. Hallelujah, Pastor. Go today and minister the word, minister healing, bring deliverance like you never did before. In the name of Jesus, amen. So, good morning. I'm Apostle Vivian Duncan on behalf of my wife, Apostle Gemma, and all the covenanters at Divine Destiny Worship Center, the house of champions, where worship is a doing word, a verb, and not a noun. And we've been having some awesome experiences in the worship. Two Sundays ago, we went into one of the songs I wrote again that says, I have a passion for your presence, and it's driving me. It's drawing me. We're going to ask our technician to give us a little bit of that, about 5 minutes of that worship. Join us in the worship. Hallelujah. I have a passion for his presence. Receive.
I have a passion for your presence.
Pushing me.
And it's pushing me.
That's what
pushing me. I have a passion for your presence.
Draws
and it's drawing me. Drawing me.
I just want to get close.
Closer and closer.
Revelation 4.
Ever so
driving me.
I have a passion for your presence, and it's drawing me,
Closer,
closer and closer.
Revelation 4,
ever so near to your throne.
I can see
the light of your glory. Like a rainbow round your throne, I can feel your warm embrace. As you bid me welcome home, I hear the sound of angels singing and cherubim as they cry. They cry, holy, holy, holy is your name.
Righteous.
They cry, righteous are you, Lord.
Pushing me.
I have a passion for your presence, and it's drawing me,
Oh God, I'm getting
closer and closer,
ever so near
to your throne.
I have
a passion for your presence. And it's driving me. I have a passion for your presence. And it's pushing me. I have a passion for your presence. And it's drawing me. Closer and closer. Ever so near.
Yes, so we are here again with the Word of God, the Word of God. I promised you last week we'll do another installment of the vintage season this week. This is just the introduction, because the time is coming when we'll do it as a full-fledged series. But the key thing is, do not drop out of the vine. Stay on the vine. Whenever a grape falls off the vine, it has no more sustenance. And maybe I'm speaking to you today. You dropped out of that church you were going to. Yes. And you have not been anywhere else. You are on your couch, drying up, on your bed, drying up. Come on, I speak to you. Wake up this Sunday morning and get to the church where you pledge to that pastor and you pledge to God, I'll be here to help you expand and fulfill the vision. Receive.
I was in Tobago at the end of June. And the Lord on the night I was to minister opened up something to me. July the 1st. On July the... I'm getting an echo, please. Hallelujah. On July the 1st. And the Lord said to me, it's vintage time. It's what?
Vintage time.
It's vintage time. So I was there in Tobago. Ready to do my portion in the conference that night. And the Lord said to me, it's vintage season. And I'm wondering, what is this? Of course, now you don't have to worry about going home to get your Collins Dictionary and all of that. I pull up my phone and I put vintage. I ask Uncle Google. And you know what? Uncle Google said to me, and do you know, it was on Saturday the 1st of July that I was ministering. And when I looked on the phone, it says, the vintage season is the season in the Middle East when the grapes come into full maturity, ready to be reaped. And the day it begins is July the 1st. On July the 1st, the Lord tells me it's vintage season for my church. Do you like if you're happy now? And it says, from July, the reaping begins, and by the end of September, it reaches its peak. Come on, give God a praise. Many years ago, and Brother Desmond will attest to that, down there in Chaguanas. We went to a camp. Well, he was part of the hit squad. Every time we traveled, we always had a hit squad with us. Down to a camp in Siparia to minister. And the anointing just went out of our hands, out of our control. And in it, we started to prophesy to the church, prophesy. And the Lord said to me, every time I want to introduce a new prophetic season to you, it will happen in the month of July. Come on, give God a praise. And how many people know that God is not worried that right now we're teaching on mentoring? He's not worried about that at all. And he said to me, he said, pursue what I tell you. And what you release to the people whom I've given to you, know that it's in the month of January you will start hearing the other prophets speaking about it. So that the people in the ministry would be advanced in the receipt of the waves and waves of revelation, and not just the revelation, but the actualization of what that prophetic season stands for. So, when I looked at the date, it's July the 1st. It coincides with the beginning of a fresh season of the prophetic for us. It also literally refers to the reaping of the grapes in the Middle East beginning on July the 1st. But we are not going to abandon our mentoring assignment, which, as I told you, in January, the Lord said to me, in fact, he said in December, what you're planning to start to do, to teach in January, which is supposed to be the visionary church of Jesus Christ, leave that alone and do mentoring. Only to see on the first day, first Sunday of 2023, every newspaper had as its headline or subheadline, 2023, the year of mentoring. Do you like it happy now? Because I don't own a newspaper. I'm not an editor of a newspaper. Neither am I a reporter for a newspaper to influence the headline. But God knows. Amen. Tell your neighbor, God already print your headline. You're struggling to get there, but watch what will happen. Hey, katayarabasa. Jesus. My God. So in sports, in the film industry, in politics, just name it, they are going after the principle of mentoring to prepare the next generation. And here comes the Lord now, and he's piling up on that revelation, the vintage season. So I thought today I will do a little introduction to it, and we'll come with more of it later in the year, because I have to finish the mentoring thing. But this is mentoring. Tell anybody, this is mentoring. Apostle is mentoring us. Into the, go ahead.
Into the
principles
and
practice
of hearing from God
and doing it how He wants it. Now look at this. What's that there? Grapes, 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 grapes. On the what? On the vine. Now, this is part of a series I do in companies. Imagine in a secular company, they sit down and their eyes are open. Oh, like they never heard that. That's in the Bible, boy. Listen, ask the Bible story and make it into training modules. The greatest source of principles for training human beings is in the Bible. Amen. I don't worry with Plato and all them fellas. Plato and them were crazy fellas. They had to smoke first, boy, before they get a... They used to write off out of hallucination. And I that's why when I hear a preacher get up to preach and the first thing he opens his mouth and says is, Socrates said. Who's Socrates? Plato said. They were madmen. Many of them killed themselves. Why would I quote somebody like that? When I have Jesus. Amen. I said, when I have Jesus. Amen. Who gave himself to be killed for my sake. So in the Bible, the Lord opened up this to me. It's under the heading team. I spoke to the officers of our credit union yesterday. Just touched a little bit concerning teamwork. Tell anybody the team works. Now, do you know that bunch of grapes, or each bunch of grapes represent a team? Do you know every grape here depends on the other grapes to stay on the bunch? Do you know no grape, no grape on this bunch could tell itself, you see me, I get out of here, yes? What do you think will happen to that grape? It will shrivel up. My survival is built into me remaining on the bunch. Tell neighbor that for me. But I want you to understand that it's not easy to be part of a bunch. Especially if you are in the middle of the bunch. Boy, it's like everybody taking a turn on you. And you can't say nothing. Because if a grape opens its mouth and say, yo, you're squeezing me. By the time he say, he can't even finish the yo, he gonna fall off. The key element to this bunch in vintage season, to this bunch, or to the bunch called the Church of Jesus Christ, the key element and the key responsibility, no, element first. The key element, first of all, the key principle is to stay on the bunch. Tell neighbor that for me. But what is it that will make you the grape, you the person, you the member of the bunch, stay? Tell a neighbor it's called tolerance. I say it's called tolerance. I say it again, Laura, it's called tolerance. If you don't develop tolerance as part of your profile, you will fall off and dry up. Because there's no way, if that little grape falls on the ground, you say, hey, look, let me go back, eh? Down here, boy, have cockroach. Ants. Rats. Down here, have, what do you call it? There's a plague called wastage. No, not that the grapes falling off represent waste, you know. There is a device, there is a spirit, there is an element in nature that will put to waste anything that's not attached. Are you hearing me? And he works with a partner called rotten. And another partner called spoil. And there's another one called sour. Sweet, sweet grapes that get sour down here. Healthy looking grapes begins to lose its luster when it falls out. When it chooses, because they're squeezing me. They think I come just so what? Everybody squeezing me. He squeezing me. Them up there squeezing me. Them on the side squeezing me. And since I'm in the center, there's more weight coming on upon them on top of me and weight coming on top of them. And I get all the squeezing in me like, you see, I can't do it. And that's what happened. And what keeps happening in the body of Christ People have not learned how to be tolerant.
Hallelujah. We give God praise. We look out for you this Sunday morning. My God, we would have just returned from the launch of a Caribbean-wide apostolic ministry called CARICAM. The power of God, the grace of God, the anointing of God was so awesome. It's amazing. Yes, right here in the Caribbean. You don't really have to travel to Europe and England and America and so on again to get a strong anointing, a strong prophetic apostolic grace, a strong word from God, healing, deliverance. Yes, it has always been here, but we had not organized it like it is now. And so from every island of the Caribbean, every nation, there is a person that carries that apostolic grace. This Sunday morning, we'll be talking about it as well. Be with us. Hallelujah. We are going somewhere doing something great for this great God that we serve. Amen. And we are in the month of August, as you would know, we are not online or in the house of God doing service. We take a break during the month of August. But when we come to September, we are coming back with a bang, as it were, online. But we are in the house of God physically. Amen. When we say online, we talk about the Thursday and Friday sessions. Of course, we are online every Sunday morning with the service being beamed from, yes, Diego Martin to all our branches. And well, some people have made their home as another branch. But Chaconas, Faizabad, Sangre Grande, and up in Antigua and out in Tobago, it's beamed with the same grace and anointing. So we give God praise, and we look forward to seeing you this Sunday morning. So until we meet again, I'm Apostle Vivian Duncan, on behalf of my wife, Apostle Gemma, and all the covenanters at Divine Destiny Worship Center, the House of Champions, declaring to you, you began life as a winner. Don't live it as a victim or die as a loser. You're a God idea, because when God made you, he had destiny on his mind. God bless you until we meet again. Amen and amen.
Na 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 na. Yeah, 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 yeah. La Trinity, we come to thee. You are our namesake. You will never forsake. You said if we.
Continue to reach your goals through Jesus Christ. This has been It's Your Date with Destiny, a production of Divine Destiny Media Ministry. Until next time, you began life as a winner. Don't live life as a victim or die as a loser. For when God made you, he had destiny on his mind.